cual me voy. El ferro, el Porsche, la C3 o el Rolls Royce. El bote parqueado en San Croix. Viviendo la vida como si se va a acabar hoy. Yo, tranquilo, en la mía es que estoy. El Richard Zafiro, Dios me los bendiga. Mis hijos no nacer otro como Floyd. La baby le llegan los míos. Al día no le falta nada. Las guaguas son negras, están todas blindadas. Tu ronca allá afuera, aquí tú no eres nada. Porque mi tiempo me vale dinero. No te asustes si te enseño todos los ceros. La vida me bendijo porque me mero. Soy mi jefe, eso hago lo que yo quiero. Aquí arriba no llegan. Tú sabes que aquí es real. Mere, me vengo a afrontar. Pregúntale al banquero, son 3 melones semanal. No existe quien me va a parar. Se juntaron todos para quererme frenar. Saludo a la federal y al estatal. Cambiaste la...
Well, the Santa Ana winds are kicking, leaving us nothing but clear skies over Dodger Stadium in L.A. Today, a notable matchup of playoff hopefuls between the San Diego Padres and the Los Angeles Dodgers. With Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa in the booth, and guys, a game today that features what would be the 2 wildcard teams if the season ended as it stands now.
Yeah, both of these teams battling to stay in postseason position, Matty, at least in this wildcard race, so this game is going to have a huge impact. Not only are they both trying to keep their lead on the other teams in this race, but they're also potentially jockeying for home field advantage in a wild card game by trying to grab that top wild card spot. Basically, every game for these clubs means a lot from here on, so I expect to see an exciting one here.
Max Scherzer gets the start for Los Angeles in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Max Scherzer. Hello, Chief. It's Max, and it's not Agent 99. This is one of the best pitchers in the game of baseball. Upper to mid-90s fastball, powerhouse slider, and a great changeup. If he brings his A game, it's lights out for the opposing team.
Here's the first pitch.
First pitch, 110.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control, 0-2. Scherzer racked up over 2,300 innings of work on major league mounds and logged in with an ERA in the low threes. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect for the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
And that'll bring in Adam Frazier. As he'll take a good look at a curveball that sweeps right across the zone in there for the first strike. And he's got that batting lineup near the 300 mark entering play. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1.
Looked like he was going to wait him out, see if he was going to come over the heart of the plate. Well, newsflash, he is, and this hitter's going to adjust his batting gloves, and he better be ready in the box.
One out, nobody on. A ball and two strikes now.
Pretty standard fastball right there, 0-2. Now he's changed the eye level of the batter so he can start working something in like an off-speed curveball down in the zone.
Two and two to Adam Frazier.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
That misses, so the count goes full now to the second batter of the ballgame.
Boy, went from being in the driver's seat to now being in some trouble. Had the count 0-2, started nipping at the corners, and next thing you know, this count stands at 3-2.
Now the payoff pitch home. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
two ways to look at this walk. If you're the hitting coach, you say, that's a great AB. Down 0-2 and you work the walk. But if you're a pitcher like me, that's just a case of letting a guy off the hook, and that can really frustrate you.
So a runner at first with one out now. And standing in now, the always dangerous third baseman, Manny Machado. He's set. Here it comes. As Scherzer's able to move ahead of him with strike one.
For most people, being down 0-1 would seem like a lot, but this guy is such a good hitter. He doesn't care going deep in the count. He's got runners on base. He has a game plan every time he comes to the plate. Let's see how this one plays out.
From the stretch. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew working this one. Behind the plate is Eric Summersgill.
You know what, Dan? I'm always baffled when Eric Summersgill's behind the dish because he has a tendency to favor one side of the plate.
You know, that's one of the things I think pitchers get a little bit frustrated with the E-train at time. It's like, hey, if you're going to give me that inside quarter, give it to me, but don't keep moving the dish around on me all game.
From the belt, kicks and deals. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Frazier, base runner at first with one out. Still even at 2-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
And he misses again, ball four, and that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Some guys take a little time to find the zone, but with the second walk of the first inning, it might be a little more than just settling in here. Not sure how long of a leash they'll give him, but they're not going to let him walk the world out there.
Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr. From the belt, the pitch.
This looks like it could be a rough one. He can't throw a strike, and it's only the first inning. I'm not sure he's going to be around here very long.
Here's a swing and a little tapper in front of the mound. Oh, and that all developed too late to get him at first, and now the bases are loaded here.
Well, some games take a little time to heat up, but not this one. We're just five batters in, and the bases are already juiced. Almost hate to say it, but this might be the turning point of the game already.
First baseman Eric Hosmer is in as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. The numbers on the year, 272, 11 home runs, 57 runs batted in. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. Smoked on the ground up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. One run scores. And he is in there.
Hey, one of the things you want to do, D-Row, is strike early, and they've done just that with a big hit driving in, too.
Yeah, Dan, great to grab an early lead right there, especially when you could throw up a crooked number for your pitcher.
To the plate now, Tommy Pham. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Big pitch coming up right here. He'd love for a ground ball or a strikeout.
He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
So here's Will Myers. He offers at it and hits it in the air to left. Lux will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. It's the Padres 2 and the Dodgers nothing. Blake Snell will be the man on the mound for the Friars. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
You know, the key for Blake Snell is getting him out on that mound every 5 days. He's had some injuries over the course of his career, but there's no doubting the stuff. He's another guy, upper 90s fastball, good curveball. His slider's gotten a lot better, and he'll mix in an occasional changeup. This guy has a chance to be a dynamic pitcher every time he takes the mound.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch.
That's a ball.
Now the 1-0.
Nope, that's a ball.
Took something off there, but this is hit well anyway, out to deep center. Back goes Grisham to the track, to the wall. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. A solo home run there for Mookie. Number 21 for him on the season. And the Dodgers are within a run. It's now 2-1.
I think it's time to start pitching around this guy. He's hit three home runs already in the series. I'm not sure what more they need to see, but this is not the guy I want to be pitching to right now.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. He'll check in here at 256. 32 home runs and 83 runs batted in. One and one to the Dodgers first baseman.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left a yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
And they'll run this one in on him, and he can't connect, so he finds himself down one and two now.
Oh, I love that pitch right there. Up and in, jam sandwich.
Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul.
Can we be honest here? That was a terrible pitch. That was right over the heart of the plate, two strikes on the guy. He is lucky he's getting this pitch back.
Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at two and two. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Another try at 2-2. This is popped up. Under it is Machado, and he'll take it for the first out.
Batting third. The second
base. Time now to check out how the hometown Dodgers line up in this one. Thoughts, Dan, who stands out?
Well, I'm going to have to keep a close eye on Trey Turner. He's got a batting average of over 400 with runners in scoring position coming into this one. I love watching him in those situations because he gets really dialed in. Hopefully we get to see some of that today.
And here he is right on cue. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The average to start play at 315. 21 homers and 58 runs batted in. And he misses again, 2-0.
2-0 to a guy with this kind of pop, you better be awfully careful because he's going to be swinging out of his shoes.
2-1, the count to Trey Turner.
Yeah, this is one of my biggest pet peeves in the game when guys get count leverage and take fastballs. It's a game of fastballs. You calibrate everything off the heater. Surprising take right there.
Pham is going to get there as he backs up to put it away, and there are two gone now.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
At the plate now, Justin Turner. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. A one pitch on its way. Got him to go after that one, and he's in a quick hole, 0-2.
Hey, I got to commend him a little bit. Lead off homer, and now he's one pitch away from getting...
Well, leave it right there as he strikes out, and that ends the inning. The Dodgers do get one back on the solo home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's the Padres 2 and the Dodgers 1. And now, Austin Nola, and he'll lead things off against Max Scherzer.
The catcher, Austin Nola.
Now here's the first offering. Grounder down the line at third. And close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one.
The pitcher,
next to dig in, Blake Snell. First delivery to him. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Betts has a read on it. Two gone. So it's back to the top of the order now. And that brings up Trent Grisham. And now the first pitch. Just got a piece to the right side.
Hey, when you're featuring a mid-90s fastball like this pitcher, attack with that pitch. Get ahead. Get the offense on their toes. That opens up the off-speed pitches later in the game.
High in the air into shallow left center. In comes the left fielder. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. They still lead it 2-1. So now into the box is Corey Seager. And as you can see, he's had some troubles here in his own ballpark. That's something he'll look to improve upon in this one. Field shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Lays off again, and it's 2-0. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is aboard.
Sometimes you just got to trust your hands. That pitch probably wasn't even in the that zone, and he was able to fight it off for a base hit. Well.
Here now is Will Smith. as he'll watch a breaking ball that comes back to catch the outside corner for strike one. 268 the average for him coming in. 23 homers and 69 runs batted in. Oh, and he sat on the curveball there and yanks this one out to left. This ball has plenty of carry to it, and it's going to clear the wall by plenty. A home run. So a two-run homer down the line and left. 24 home runs for him on the season, and it's given the Dodgers a 3-2 lead.
As soon as this thing left the bat, you knew it had the distance to get out of here. The only question was whether it was going to stay fair or not. And that question was answered with a resounding doink as it caromed off the foul pole for a homer.
In now, Steven Souza. As he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Here's the pitch. Turned on, but that's ripped foul down the third baseline. 1-1. He swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Threw that fastball right by him. He had no chance to get the barrel to that one.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
It's never easy to rebound after serving up a two-run shot, but that at-bat was a good indication to me that he isn't letting it get to him. He went right after him for the strikeout.
The batter will be Gavin Lux. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. The windup and the 0-1. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly by Hosmer. Throw on to first, two gone. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that'll bring up one of the better hitting pitchers in Max Scherzer. First pitch on the way. Swing and a liner. But this lands foul for the first strike. Well behind that fastball, it's a swinging strike.
You know that nasty changeup's lurking right here. If I'm in the batter's box, I have to tell myself to stay back. I have to take pull side out of the equation, or that changeup's going to beat me.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there, and the inning is over. But the Dodgers do strike for two, coming on this two-run home run. We've played two, and Los Angeles has taken a 3-2 lead. Now with the plate is Adam Frazier, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Adam Frazier.
First pitch of the AB now. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Grounded softly to the right. Turner fields it cleanly. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third. So with one gone in the inning, we take a look at our current standings, and you can see that these guys trailed by just a game and a half in the division race entering play today. Here's Manny Machado now. No official at-bat for him, but he has scored a run in this one. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Now the 1-0. pulled high in the air out to left field. Lux is camped under this one. Two gone. So next to bat will be Fernando Tatis Jr. Now the first pitch. Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike.
Man, this guy's in a good groove right now. Seven straight retired. He's locked in.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Third inning, already a 3-2 ball game. Can't quite get around in time to keep it fair, and it remains 0-2. Now a fastball here that'll wisely lay off, and it's 1-2.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
The 1-2. In the air down the line in left. Left fielder giving chase. Into the corner. He makes the catch to end the inning. Padres down in order. They trail 3-2. I'm in my zone now. Money don't slow down.
I'm grown now. Welcome back as the Dodgers prepare for their third turn batting in this one. And fans of the Boys in Blue have been treated to quite a bit of production from this lineup so far this year. They enter the day among the league leaders in both home runs and runs scored. So it's no secret what a threat they present to opposing pitching staffs. As one player told me earlier, we've got a stacked lineup, so as long as we all show up to swing it every day, we're going to cause a lot of problems for the other guys. It's a fun group of guys to hit with. Matt, back to you.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks.
Leading up for the Dodgers.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And standing in is the veteran outfielder,
Mookie Betts. Yeah, and he wasn't fooled at all by the changeup last time. Kept his hands back and absolutely destroyed that ball. So I got to think he's not going to see a changeup in this scenario right here.
Behind on that one. Now behind in the count, 0-1. Here, strike two as the slider hits the outside corner. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Boy, he sped him up in this at-bat. Now it's time for the changeup. This guy's got a good one, and he hasn't thrown it yet in this at-bat.
Here comes the 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Next up is Max Muncy, as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. Ball two. Outside, 3-0 now.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
Now a half swing here as he wanted to pull it back, but he does so too late. It's strike one. That one yanked just foul. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a ball lined hard toward deep right field. Myers is back in. Plenty of time to put this away, however, and there are two gone.
Now back, second baseman, Trey Turner.
Here now is Trey Turner, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. Swing and a liner, but this lands foul down there to make it 1-1.
Super important situation right here for the pitcher to go 1-2-3. Get back in the dugout, regroup. He struggled early, but if he can knock out this 1-2-3 inning, I think he can right the ship.
Grounded down the third baseline. Taken in by Machado. Throw in time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. Digging in now for San Diego, Eric Hosmer. He was able to plate two with a base hit in his first appearance. Now the pitch. In there at the knees, strike one.
What a well-executed fastball right there, down and away. If you're going to do any damage with that pitch, you have to think up the middle the other way, and you have to be diving and leaning out over that thing.
Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Lux is under it, one away. So one down, no one aboard. And up next, it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham. Ready to deal, here comes the first pitch. Strike one to start the at-bat. Two runs on two hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. And here's a foul ball just off to the right as they get ahead of him here. Nothing in two. Here comes Scherzer on 0-2. And that is swung on and missed. He's down on strikes. And the first two are retired here to begin inning number four. Now to the plate. Here is Will Myers. Flew out in his only at-bat so far. First pitch of the AB now. And they start him with one high and away for ball one. I had him lunging at that pitch away, and it's 1-1 now.
Hey, that was a nasty pitch right there. Ton of rotation on that ball. You could almost see the red dot from up here. Nasty depth.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. Three up, three down for San Diego. Still a 3-2 ball game. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And standing in is the veteran third baseman, Justin Turner. Now the first pitch. Line drive, base hit into the left center field gap. And this will bang up against the wall. And he will pull into second with a leadoff double.
Well, you look at his numbers, and there's no doubt he's faring much better against lefties, hitting better than 400 against them this season. And when you see swings like this, you can see why.
Here's Corey Seager. Hit in the air down the right field line. Myers is under it. He makes the catch, and the runner from second will tag and hit for third. And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away. Now a man at third with one away, and that brings up Will Smith.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run in that last at bat. That ball was down and away. He went out and hooked it and pulled it. This guy's definitely a good hitter.
1-0 the count. Turner takes his lead at third with one away. And there's a fastball well off the plate inside.
That's not some bad pitching right there. You're two pitches down, but you have a runner on third, and you know this hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can hit in the air for a sacrifice fly.
3-0 now. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Ball four.
Well, some might say a walk there is okay because you've got first base open, but he's been struggling out there. And if you're going to work around hitters, you don't want to work around hitters in the bottom of the lineup.
Next up for Los Angeles, Steven Souza. He's 0-for-1 thus far. First pitch on its way. In the dirt and block behind the plate. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. So the lead runner holds on, but the trailer will take second. The 1-0. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. We're in the fourth. 3-2 is our score. Fouled off. Another 1-2 delivery.
Good take right there. He's given him a great battle with guys in scoring position. We'll see who's going to win this duel.
Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Yeah, the pitching coach would hate to go to the bullpen this early in the game, but sometimes you have no choice. On the flip side, he might just get in his face a little bit out there, try to challenge him, wake him up from his funk. Either way, we'll see how it works.
So it's bases loaded, one away, and up next will be Gavin Lux. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Skied down the left field line. Left fielder is on the move, and he makes the catch in the corner. And this will go down as a sack fly and an RBI as it's now a 4-2 game.
Obviously, he's hoping for more up there with the bases loaded, but you can't be too upset with a sack fly.
So So here's the Dodgers pitcher, Max Scherzer, comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. First offering. Now a curveball misses inside.
He's not having his best outing in this one, and I think that curveball is part of the reason why. He couldn't get on top of that one, and that's not the first time that's happened.
1-0 count, here it is.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Four runs, four hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. Outside, 3-0 now.
It's amazing how guys can lose focus sometimes when the weaker hitters come up, especially the pitchers. You got to stay on the attack and minimize pitches and get these guys out in a hurry.
That one's right down the middle for a strike with the fastball.
Even though it's early on in this one, anytime you get runners in scoring position, you'd like to knock them in.
The 3-1 pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Here's Mookie Betts. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Looking to minimize the damage here. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And not in time as the run scores. And the second run will score here as they open things up to a 6-2 advantage.
Boy, this guy's having a great game here so far, D-Ro. Home run earlier in the night. And that base hit right there drives in his third run batted in of this game.
Yeah, you drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup. And that's exactly been the case today. He not only mixed in that big bomb, but now he's got three ribbies to boot.
Craig Stammen answers the call from the pen here in the fourth as they didn't get the outing they were hoping for from their starter. And now here is Max Muncy. He's got a chance to add on to what's already been a big inning for them.
Yeah, two on here and three on the board already. They've absolutely come out and forced the issue of this inning. Matt, a hit here could really fire up that dugout.
Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch.
Hey, this dude's clearly capable of clearing the bases with one swing. So I think the approach to this guy is trying to keep the ball off the plate. See if they can get him to chase something.
The 1-0 is swung on and missed in that strike one.
Guess where he's going with this next pitch? Probably a little further outside. See if the fish are still biting.
Check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. The 1-2 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike three. So they pick up three runs on only two hits in the inning, no errors, and two men left on base. On to the top of inning number five we go. LA's on top, 6-2. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Leading off for San Diego.
Thank you, Heidi.
The catcher. Austin Nola.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's one and two. And he fouls this one off. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone.
I always like watching pitchers that attack with their fastballs until there's a reason to start mixing it up. He hasn't needed many of the secondary pitches so far on this one, and there was another good fastball for a strikeout there.
Jake Cronenworth
will come on as a pinch hitter to try and make an impact with one away. First offering on its way. The average sitting right at 270 on the year, 18 homers and 61 RBIs. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. And wow, a very high strike, but a strike nonetheless, and it's 1-1. Fastball well outside. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball.
Although he doesn't use that pitch too much, if he's able to steal some strikes early in the count, could be something they have to think about.
Oh, and he can't catch up to the fastball as he swings and misses for the second out.
He's really on a roll right now on the mound. Back-to-back strikeouts to wrap up the last inning, and now he started this frame with the same story, four straight strikeouts in all.
First pitch on its way. Trent Grisham is in with two away as he takes a ball, 1-0.
Man, this guy has retired a whole slew right now. I think what he needs to do is just stay focused and keep attacking the game plan like he has up to this point, because everything he's done has worked.
And the pitch.
Ball that now.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Over the outside half, and it's 2-1.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now. Looking to set down the side on strikes. Here it comes. 3-2 now.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
Count still full. 3-2.
He's one pitch away from striking out the side, but even more than that, to throw a donut up after your offense put up some runs, I can't tell you what that means to the boys in the dugout.
Heading out towards shallow right. Souza is under it, and that ends the inning. Padres down in order. They still trail here. It's 6-2. Daniel Hudson will come on now as he'll be appearing in his 45th game this year. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and set to go is the second baseman, Trey Turner. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. This is line to left. Pham is there, and he has it for the out. So here's the cleanup hitter, Justin Turner. He doubled his last time up.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
Ball one to start the at-bat. The 1-0 home.
Two balls, no strike.
One out, nobody on. Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Inside with the fastball, and he works the base on balls.
And with the bases empty, you don't feel bad about walking that guy. He's capable of taking deep every time he digs in, so it's not the worst thing in the world to work around him if you can.
Next at the plate will be Corey Seager. First pitch of the AB on its way. Swing and a ball hit well to the right side, but this will get into the crowd. On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
I got a ball, one strike.
One of the best ways to keep a guy uncomfortable is to pound him inside. They're doing that, and this one caught the zone.
Turner leads off first with one away. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
That strikeout was all about setting the hitter up with hard stuff. You can see the first three pitches are coming in fast, and then he slows it down on the fourth pitch, knowing the hitter is sort of conditioned for the hard stuff. Yet another way to upset a hitter's timing.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. He'll swing and lift a ball foul off to the left and out of play. It was a walk in his last trip. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Swing and a miss as he pulls the top hand over. It's 0-2.
I know this guy has a lot of weapons on the mound, but what makes him so successful is that he's aggressive in the zone, getting ahead, forcing action.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Grounded to short. He's got it. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Dodgers leave one. They lead it 6-2. So here's Adam Frazier. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, let's see if he can work a walk, maybe a knock, ground ball with eyes, something. Catch a gap to get this offense going. Two hits as a team can start demoralizing your confidence. But if he can get on and start some traffic in motion, we might have something.
As he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. Line to shortstop, and there's one away.
The third baseman, number 13, Manny Machado.
And in steps Manny Machado, 0-1 with a run scored thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. Ball one. Machado has all the necessary skills to play great defense on the left side of the infield, and it makes him really fun to watch. He can pick it with the best of them, but what sets him apart is the huge arm. It's accurate, it's incredibly strong, certainly has the ability to uncork a throw and beat a runner when he needs to, and it's impressive to watch.
Yeah, anybody that has the ability to go to their backhand and to absolutely fire a cannon across the infield.
Now Manny turns on one and sends it to deep left. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. It's a solo home run off the bat of Manny Machado. Number 25 for him on the year. And with that, it's now a 6-3 ball game.
No surprise with that swing of the bat. This guy is simply one of the best in the game right now. There's not too many guys that take a beautiful hack like that in the league.
And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. The 1-0 home. Misses, ball two.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
3-0 now. On deck, there's Eric Hosmer. Padres shortstop ahead with a three ball, one strike count.
You maybe get two pitches a game where all the guesswork goes out the window. This is certainly that situation.
And the 3-1. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Here comes the payoff pitch. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The next 3-2. And he takes ball four, so he's on. And as you know, that often means the steal could be in order here.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Next, it'll be Eric Hosmer. He flew out in his last AB. From the stretch, here's the pitch. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Some action out in the bullpen, couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. The 1-0 finds the zone, strike one, using the slide step to try to control the running game.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
Here's Scherzer now, 1-1. Now a changeup, but it misses just a little below the zone.
It's one thing to get hit around, but it's far worse when you're getting yourself into trouble by not throwing strikes. Every pitcher's been there, but it doesn't make it any less frustrating or unacceptable.
He pulls this one into right. Souza is there, two down.
Now back, left fielder, Tommy.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and up next it'll be the outfielder, Tommy Pham. From the stretch. Nope. Fastball here too low, and it's 1-0.
With that base running threat on first base, man, does that change the pitcher's whole mentality. This guy at the plate should assume nothing but heaters coming right at him.
Pitch taken, several inches below the zone, in fact.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job in this at-bat trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
Now the 2-0 home is a fastball well off the plate but offered at for a strike.
I mean, he had to. I'm going to give him benefit of the doubt and say he was sitting something off speed, because to be late on a fastball in a count like that is just unforgivable.
Tatis is off of first with two away. And another foul ball. That misses, and it's going to set up a big pitch now. 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. Next to hit is Will Myers. He flew out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim most recently. Hoping to limit the damage, here's the pitch.
After the walk and with runners on the bags, he couldn't afford to fall behind here. Nice job of jumping ahead with strike one.
Takes this the other way to right. That's in there. Base hit. Tatis rounds third and is digging for the plate. The tag, and he's safe as it's now a two-run game.
Hey, D-Rod, I think we got a case right now. This team, they're just feasting on a pitcher that he's given up some runs, and it looks like he's starting to get a little bit tired, leaving some of these pitches up in the zone.
Yeah, and I think there's a fight at the bat rack right now. Guys are licking their chops, knowing he's a little bit tired, going to leave stuff over the middle of the plate. Won't be surprised to see the bullpen get going.
That'll bring up Austin Nola. No balls and one strike. Set to deliver the 0-1. Down and away, ball one.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
And it's fouled away. Fouled off. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. So it's two runs here on two hits, with one of them being a home run. Bottom part of the order, 7, 8, and 9, due up in the home half. Dodgers lead this one 6-4. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll bring up the outfielder, Steven Souza Jr.
The right fielder, Steven Souza Jr.
And now the first pitch. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Comes set and the 0-1. That's strike two on a well-placed changeup around the knees.
Sometimes you just can't overthink it. If a guy can't hit a certain pitch in a certain quadrant, why would you throw him anything else? Case in point, this guy's cold zone is away, and this pitcher keeps attacking that exact spot.
The 1-2. And he takes a good swing at that one as this is sent down the line in right, but ultimately into the crowd, a foul ball. Now another 1-2. And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And this misses, and Hudson goes to a full count now. It's 3-2.
And just when you needed a shutdown inning, a leadoff walk was certainly not on the agenda. He needs a bear down right here.
The 3-2 pitch gets him looking up around the letters. And with one away, we show you a look at where these guys sit in the current division race. And basically, they're left with no hope. Next for the Dodgers, Gavin Lux notched an RBI on the sac fly in his previous turn at the plate. Now here's the first offering. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Really deceptive changeup right there. It died right before the plate, and he was left reaching for air.
Fastball misses inside. It's even at 1.
That's not an easy pitch to do anything with, right? 96 miles an hour in on the hands. You almost have to be looking for that pitch to be able to do anything with that.
Now this is swung on and hit down to Machado at third. And there's out number 2. Matt Beatty will pinch hit here with 2 outs and the bases empty. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. He comes in at 262 on the year. 5 homers and 34 driven in. Changeup stays outside and he's behind 2-0. 2 out, nobody on. Two balls and a strike. Now the 2-1 pitch. Even count, 2 balls and 2 strikes. And he tries to get him to reach for it, but it stays outside, 3-2.
Well, he really needs to make this guy swing the bat right here. He's not the type of hitter you want to dance around with.
3-2 pitch. High and deep to left center field. Back goes Grisham at the track. And he gets there as he had a lot of ground to cover that time, and the side is retired. Dodgers down in order. They still lead it 6-4. Shane Green is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. Jake Marisnik is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. He'll enter play with that batting average, still shy of the 220 mark. 5 homers, and he's driven in 24. Boy, that's just about in the catcher's glove there. It's 0-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
And to hit will be Trent Grisham, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. That evens it up, 1-1. Nearly got the inside, but ruled a ball. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Sinker, 3-2 now.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Now the payoff pitch home, and he looks at ball four now, so he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Stepping in next, Adam Frazier. He represents the potential tying run if he can launch one or find a way around the bases.
Yeah, Matt, I kind of doubt he's thinking about going yard, even though that would be the best result they could hope for. He's not a long ball threat, and he knows it, so he could just be looking for some way to keep that line moving.
Prior to the at-bat, a check on first, and he just manages to get his hand in. From the belt, kicks and deals. And a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Well-thrown sinker that time, down but in the strike zone.
He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep the ball around the knees like that.
Grisham, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Throw over to the bag, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Wisely lays off the cut fastball there. It's 2-1. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Manny Machado, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle. The 3-1 pitch. Lifted the other way down the left field line. Lux is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. At the plate now is Manny Machado. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Set and the pitch, and a sinker dips too low there, into the dirt in fact. A runner on first with two away. A ball and a strike now to Machado.
You know, most people would be surprised he took that right there, because that looked like it was in his honey hole. He had to obviously be sitting on something else.
1-2 now, as that's in there at the knees.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive in a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
Outside and low that time. Now it's two balls and two strikes. Two out with the man at first.
Runner, runner,
there goes the runner. Fouled away. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. A dive, but it's off his glove. Grisham blows through the stop sign, headed for home. Is in time, and he's cut down at the plate as they team up to gun him down. One left for San Diego. They trail it here 6-4. Making a contribution, so that makes me the solution. Emilio Pagan is on out of the bullpen now as he gets to work in his 60th game of the season. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts as the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Now the 1-0. A bouncer to the left side. Reined in. Throw to first is in time for the first out. All right, so let's turn to show track for a more in-depth look at that one. Good reaction, great range, and a nice backhanded stop, and the jump throw with a lot behind it all the way across the infield for the out. The numbers don't lie, and that was pretty spectacular. At the plate, Max Muncy, and he fouls this one off. Pagan is a reliever known for forcing contact. Not a huge strikeout guy most of the time, but he also doesn't issue a lot of free passes either.
There's a couple of keys to being a good reliever. One, if you have great stuff and you strike everybody out, or like this guy, not afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. He has good stuff, not great stuff. He's not afraid to let his defense help him out and make some plays.
Here it comes on 1-1, and it's fouled away. Swing and a miss at the curveball, and there's your second out of the inning.
Pretty textbook breaking ball for the punch out right there. Got it to bend a lot, and by the time it got there, it had fallen completely out of the zone. Not much you can do with that pitch.
The speedy Trey Turner digs in now. Scooped up. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're up 6-4. Number 63 gets the call from the bullpen to pitch in relief.
Number 63.
All set for the start of the inning. And stepping in will be the very fleet-footed Fernando Tatis Jr.
This is the part of the game where I think we really start seeing what teams are made of, both in terms of battling back, showing some resiliency, and in terms of knowing how to play with the lead, locking down that W.
No balls and a strike to count. Here's the 0-1. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now. On They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. And with strike three recorded there, he's notched his first career major league strikeout.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have at least one pitch that they can go into in tough situations. So we'll see if he becomes one of those guys as his career goes along.
Eric Hosmer to the plate now. Line towards center field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he'll reach second now with one away.
That's what you call a clutch piece of hitting. Down two runs, he puts himself in scoring position and brings the tying run to the plate. We'll see what they do with the base open here. This one's getting interesting.
Into the box now, Tommy Pham, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Now the 0-1.
You got to cover the whole plate now after letting him steal two strikes on the inside half.
Got him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time.
This pitching staff has done a really good job against this guy in this series. This is a really good hitter. It's not easy to make a guy strike out five times in a series up to this point, but that's what they've done to this guy so far.
Here's Will Myers. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. The 1-0.
Watching him on the mound right now, I think he's just having trouble throwing strikes to this guy. Up only two runs, I don't think he's working around him.
Hosmer at second with two down. Hit hard to short. And that's through into left, a base hit. And the runner at third will put the brakes on here as they didn't want to chance it even with two outs.
Now that little ground ball with eyes right there. He might have been a little bit out in front, but I don't care. That's a bullet knock in the box score tomorrow morning.
Now time is called and a bit of a curious decision here to say the least as we'll get a pinch runner at third here. Don't know if something's wrong or what. Ready now is Austin Nola. And Dan, this could be a real make or break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
For the first pitch, a check at first, and he's back in standing. Here's the first pitch to him.
There are a couple points in every game that could decide winning or losing. This is one of those critical spots. Time to make some great pitches.
Runners on first and third, two away. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. And they have taken the lead. So a three-run blast to left center as they move out in front 7-6.
Well, this guy's been unhittable all year, but eventually you knew somebody would get to him. That's the first home run he's given up all year. But like all good relievers, he has to have a short memory and put it behind him.
Corey Knebel
enters the ballgame out of the pen, looking for the final out here in the top of inning number 8. Victor Caratini will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Victor Caratini.
First pitch on the way. As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage of it.
Yeah, you know, Dero, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But the Padres pick up 3 on this 3-run home run. Home half of the 8th coming up. It's the Friars 7 and the Dodgers 6. Denelson Lamed is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the 8th. Jurickson Profar is going to come on as a defensive replacement now as he takes over at first base. Bottom of the inning now, and set to go as the third baseman, Justin Turner. First pitch coming, here it is. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball 1-0. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And 2-0 now as this misses below the knees.
Don't expect this pitcher to throw something over the heart of the plate. He's going to have to stay on the corners right here. Huge spot in this game. Do not miss over the heart and get beat.
Too high. And it's 3-0.
Well, he was definitely looking fastball here, and he got one. But that was good discipline to lay off and get himself into a 3-0 count.
Turner in front at 3 balls and a strike. Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Fastball called, strike 3, and there's the first out of the inning.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
Here's Corey Seager as he would look at a first pitch fastball for ball 1. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the 1-0. Lifted the other way down the left field line, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-1 home is taken for ball 2. Fouled off. Fouled away. Bases are empty, 1 man out. And he fouls this one off. Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. He'll try it again, 3-2. Back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. And there are two away now. Two away for the Dodgers here in the eighth. And that brings up Will Smith. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. In for a strike, it's 1-1. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Bases are empty here with two men out. 2-2 to the Dodgers catcher. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. Nola finds it, and the throw to first ends the inning. Nothing across here this half. We've played eight full. It's the Friars 7 and the Dodgers 6. All set to start the ninth in this one, and next will be the speed threat, Trent Grisham. First pitch on its way. The 0-1 pitch.
One ball, one strike.
Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Set and the 2-1 pitch fouled off. Fastball is outside and it's full now, 3-2. Full count still. Yanked hard, but foul to the right.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Finally, just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Adam Frazier. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. One 0 count, here it is. Popped high in the air. Muncy is there. Two gone. Manny Machado will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. first pitch of the AB now as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
I'm sure every pitcher on the staff could use an extra run right here. I know the bases are empty and there's two outs, but stay on the attack. Get a guy on first base. You never know. You get something going, string a few across.
Behind 0-2 now. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off 1-2.
Stone cold take right there. That fastball very well could have sent him packing back to the bench.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time to first. He's got it. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for San Diego. They'll try and hold him in the field now. It's 7-6. Mark Melanson comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning. All set for the bottom of the ninth. Coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Steven Souza.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off of closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season. And he's blown several saves up to this point.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Two and one now to Steven Souza. The 2-1 is strike two swinging. Started to go. Did he hold up in time? Yes, says the first base umpire. It's ball three now. 3-2 pitch. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
Melanson looks in. Here's the pitch. Oh, tough to catch up when it's moving like that.
That's just a great pitch right there. Great execution. He just got that hitter to think that pitch was knee-high. Nasty diving out of the zone.
One is a cutter that misses 2-1. And he fouls this one off. Again, another foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. Two hitters, two strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Chris Taylor will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. Third baseman hugging the line here. Now the first pitch. As he'll take a look at the pitch too low, it's ball one. Two outs already on the K this inning, so he'll be looking to do better. Oh, Swing and a miss, 1-1. And it's fouled away. The Dodgers down to their final strike. 2-2 now with two out here in the ninth. Fouled off. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
Chopped toward the second baseman. Throw to first here will be in time to record the final out, and the Padres will add one more to their winning streak as this ball game is over. And this afternoon's closes at a one-run game, 7-6 today. The Padres cross the plate three times in the eighth, helping propel them to the win. Emilio Pagan earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. Mark Melanson records the save, number 38. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
The final line score for this afternoon's ballgame. For the victorious San Diego Padres, 7 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Dodgers, 6 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 42 minutes. Our paid attendance this afternoon, a sellout. 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending today's game. And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.